everybody, and welcome back to FSX once again. We're going to be doing another Pilot Edge flight. This time from Las Vegas, we're going to shoot down to Ontario and take a load. As you can see, we've actually have cans on board this airplane today instead of doing a ferry flight like we did last time. Just trying to get used to this Quality Wing 757 again. Those links are below in the description, for Pilot Edge, if you want to check that out, as well as the Quality Wing 757. So today's today's flight path should be the Boch 5 departure and Hector. It's going to be the transition as a VOR, and then the Ziggy 4 arrival in Ontario. 34-minute flight, very short. Flight level 280. Not expecting too much crazy weather or anything down there in California, but we'll keep our eyes open. And let's get in the airplane and get underway today. Alrighty, guys, got most of the stuff done here in the cockpit already in the initial reference page. As you can see there, our V speeds are 109, 117, 125. So we are going to be using a derate EPR out of here. And we're going to go with probably 49 degrees Celsius, as I had said before.
Seemed to work pretty good for us. So
let's do 49.
Victor 363,
like so.
Victor 8. Seal Beach.
Go ahead and turn on the flight directors. As we are waiting to get, we're going to get our clearance, and then we'll be able to get on out of here. How about that? Las Vegas clearance. Air transport 524 on the northeast cargo ramp. IFR to Ontario.
Air transport 524. Las Vegas clearance. Could Ontario Airport Boch 5 departure. Hector transition as filed. Climb via the SID. Departure rigs at 125.02, squawk 3533.
All right, air transport 524 clear to Ontario's filed via the Boch 5 Hector, and as filed from there, climb the SID 125.02 for that frequency and 3533 in the box.
Air transport 524, read that correct.
All right, so our readback's correct. Let's put 3533 in the box here, and we'll get the squawking. So I always want to make sure we have that ready for those guys when they need it. So 3533. There we go, in the box, like so.
What was the other aircraft call?
And I will make sure I'm a normal on Pilot Edge, and I am. So we're good to go.
Let's
we have a little bit of managing to get out of this ramp. We have to push back and then turn and all that good stuff, but we'll get her taken care of and then we'll fire up. So one thing's first we want to do is check our route. So we go to the legs, we'll open this guy up, put this over into map mode, as we can see down here, and let's step through it. We're going to Rebel. So heading 255, obviously a Rebel, then we go to Roper, then we go to Rod, then to Boch. Then we go to Hector, then Donna, Aaron, Gary, Ziggy, and then on to Ontario, and they'll give us instructions from there. So all is well there in the legs. Our route is we're going to be going over to 25 right. The reason why we're not using 25 left here at Las Vegas is because they're repaving it right now. So that is the reason behind that. We're using cost index of 77, flight level 280, and they said to climb via the SID, so we are going to do that. So actually what we can do is we can just pop that sucker all the way up to 280. Alrighty, so let's add let's put our speed in here. We'll do 125, which is V2 speed. As such,
Delta Torrance Ground, advise you have the weather and say location on the airport.
We need to get the weather, so let's get the weather really fast. That's gonna be 122.
Kilo Lima Alpha Sierra Airport Information Charlie 1841 Zulu Weather Wind Calm Visibility 10 Sky Condition Few Clouds at 15900 Temperature 19 Dew Point 2 Altimeter 2995 Advice on Initial Contact You Have Information Charlie Kilo Lima Alpha Sierra
right,
Airport
Charlie,
Information
so
Charlie 1841 Zulu
there, brother. Reason why we do that, because before we can depart out of here and we call up ground, we have to let them know we have Charlie. Altimeter is 2995, so we'll double check our settings here and make sure that's a 2995, which it wasn't. So now it will be. Bam, like so. So everything looks good to go there. Let's just do a few more things and we'll be underway. Alrighty, so let's go beacon on. Brakes are released and they are clear to push us back, and we'll start engine 2 on the way back. So let's go those into the run mode. And then here on our packs over here, let's make sure they're off. So left pack off, right pack off. That's about isolation valve open. I don't know why I can't ever say that correctly. It's just a big jumbled mess of words. Let's push back.
Terra 576 taxi parking via Sierra Main frequency.
All right, they pushed us back here. Let's go ahead and start engine number 2, please. All righty, that engine is stabilized. Let's go ahead and start engine number 1.
Cherokee 72 Tango, runway 15 left going.
Alrighty, we have 2 good starts, and we'll see you guys on.
Sierra Mike,
see you guys next time. You can clear to disconnect. So our ground guys are good down there. Let's go ahead and turn our packs on auto. We can turn the isolation valve now off, and we can turn the APU off. Alrighty, so when we get out of here, we got to be careful back there because there's a bunch of debris and FOD and all that good stuff. So let's call up ground and let them know we're ready to taxi. Las Vegas Ground, Air Transport 524 on the Northeast Cargo Ramp with Charlie IFR.
Air Transport 524, Las Vegas Ground. Would you like runway 25 left or runway 1 right?
25 left would be perfect for us.
Air Transport 524, runway 25 left. Taxi via Charlie Romeo Alpha 2, cross runway 25 right.
Alrighty, we'll taxi 25 left via Charlie Romeo Alpha 2 and we'll cross 25 right. Air Transport 524. Alrighty guys, let's release our brakes, give some taxi lights, and let's be very careful on our turnout. We don't want to blow anybody away back there. Not to mention with the whole FOD issue we got back there. We got cans that can be blown away really easy. So we're using very light thrust here. Very light thrust indeed. Even pulling back on the power so we don't blow away our marshaller. Like so. There we go. A little bit more power here. Not very much. Not much needed. So I'm gonna be very careful. And that's, you'll see the FOD back there once we start turning. I say FOD. It's not really FOD until it's actually a big problem, but FOD is just foreign object debris. Those cans right over there on the right, those could have been easily blown over by us. So we just take care in, you know, what we're doing. So we're going to go Charlie Romeo Alpha 2. All right, we got 118.75 in there for the tower frequency. And then remember, we got to put our 12502 in for our departure frequency. Let's do that right now. 125.
Cherokee 25 Tango taxi to terminal via Bravo.
0.02, like so. Even though in editing, I do have auto brakes on RTO and flaps are set at 15 for takeoff. Las Vegas Tower, Air Transport 524, ready to go. 25 left.
Air Transport 524, Las Vegas Tower, runway 25 left, come takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 25 left, Air Transport 524. All right, guys, we're clear for takeoff.
Two Sierra Mike, contact
strobes are on, landing lights are on, all that good stuff. Now, before I did a little bit of a test right before we started going, and I had that problem with the one engine just firing up on the auto throttle. It's not working right, so I'm just going to manually take care of that myself. And power set. And take off power set.
80 knots.
80 knots cross check.
V1. Rotate.
Rotate.
V2.
On up we go. Gear up.
Positive rate. Gear up.
All right, beautiful day in Las Vegas.
Air Transport 524, contact report.
Two departures, see you next time, Air Transport 524. All right, 10,000 feet, landing lights are all off, like so. All right, as we're climbing through 12.5 now, through Odeo, pass over Odeo, now we're headed to Boch. You can see the issue I was having before, the reason why we didn't use the EPR on the takeoff is because, look, when I start pulling this back, when auto throttle's engaged, look, we only have one working throttle. I don't know why it's doing that. It's just been a bug I've had in this airplane, and I can't figure it out. I need to probably ask them on the forums. They would probably know, but, you know, just kind of a pain in the butt to deal with something like that when you're on a departure, and so on and so forth. But everything's good to go. We're almost to Boch. We'll make that right turn, and we'll head to Hector VOR.
Air Transport 54, contact LA Center 126.35.
Over to LA Center on 126.35, Air Transport 524. Alright, 126.35. 2635. Oop, 35, where you at? Coming down here. 535. Oop, there we are, right there. LA Center, Air Transport 524 with you, 18.6 for 190.
Air Transport 524, LA Center, climb and maintain flight level 260.
Climb to 260, Air Transport 524. All right, on up to 260, like so. We made that turn, and now we're headed to Hector.
Air Transport 524, climb and maintain flight level 280.
On up to 280, Air Transport 524. All right, we're clear to 280. Let's go to 280, like so. We'll be there in no time. At this rate, it's the beauty of a 757. Alrighty, right now we're just kind of managing the throttle since I don't trust them too well. Let's go over here to this guy and make it a little longer so we can actually see our top of climb. Getting closer to our top of climb, then we hit the top of descent, then we'll be to Hector, and then we start our Ziggy 4 arrival into Ontario. I know everybody seems to think that I'm obsessed with the moon and clouds, but look at, there's the moon right there, and look at those clouds. That is just freaking awesome, in my opinion. I like the smaller things in life, such as the moon and the clouds and the atmosphere. It's neat stuff to me, and I think that's, you know, a lot of the reason why I became a pilot, just because I wanted to see what it was like to be up in the air. Alrighty, I flipped the auto throttle again, and we don't seem to have any problems now with the auto throttle. You know, you kind of deal with the problem on your way up, and then you do what you can. I disengaged the auto throttles and flew it manually. That's what you do. You fly the airplane first, and then now we kind of troubleshooted it, and now the auto throttle seems to be working fine. If it starts to act up on us again, we'll just disengage it and handle it by manual control. That's just the way you do it. Alrighty, we're getting closer to Hector now. Once we cross over Hector, we'll head into Donna, and then Aaron, and then Gary, and so on and so forth. We finally hit Ziggy, and ATC should be giving us some instructions soon.
Air Transport 524, cross Donna at maintain 12,000, the Ontario altimeter 3007.
Alrighty, we'll cross Donna at 12,000 and 3007 on that altimeter, thanks. Air Transport 524. Let's get the altimeter set here for when we cross under 18.
It looks like you just started at the descent before I gave you that instruction. Did the last controller give you a permission to descend?
Negative, Air Transport 524. The star just started descending us. We can go back up if you'd like.
Negative. Next time, just be aware that you really shouldn't descend until you're given instructions to do so.
All right, we're ever so slightly getting closer to Donna, 12,000 feet. ever so slightly. So just a little kind of a boring spot here, but things will get a little more heated up as we get closer. So I'll keep you guys updated along the way. Look at this. So here's the issue I have, guys. Look at this. The auto throttle is just like popping in and out. Well, now it's not doing it, of course. If we look off to the nose here, you can see we got a lot of cloud cover down there. Possible fog. Maybe things are going to take a little turn for the worse into Ontario, but nevertheless, we'll pick up the ILS if we need to be. All right, a drag's required. Let's go ahead and pull the speed brakes out as we continue descending towards Dawna here. We are below 18,000 feet. I already made the adjustment. We're at 30007. I just forgot to let you guys know about that, as you can see right there. So we do have the correct altimeter arriving into Ontario. So we'll just continue with the, oh, here we go with the auto throttle issue. No, I'm just going to turn them off and manually handle that. I don't know why it's doing that to me. I'm not going to mess with that. It's just broken. So like I said, you know, if it breaks, we're going to have to just deal with it ourselves. And that's what we're doing. Managing speed.
Transport 524, contact SoCal Approach 135.4.
Over to SoCal Approach on 135.4, Air Transport 524. All right, 135.4 they want us on, so let's do that. 35.4. So 3 and 4 right there. SoCal Approach, Air Transport 524 with you, 12,000.
Air Transport 524, SoCal Approach, Ontario, altimeter 3007. Fly heading 200, vectored ILS runway 26 right, final approach course.
All right, turning to heading 200, and we'll expect the ILS 26 right, Air Transport 524. All righty, so heading 200 now.
Air Transport 524, descend and maintain. Sorry about that, I'd look for it. Send to maintain 900,000 and give me your best rate of descent, please.
Down to 900,000, best descent for Air Transport 524. 900,000, guys.
Air Transport 524, fly heading 180, descend to maintain 4,000.
Air Transport 524. 4,000 now. 180, come on. Over to heading 180. We're going to be crossing through 10,000 feet. We're going to be the ILS 26 right approach.
Air Transport 524, I'm going to have you continue flying heading 180, and you can expect that to go through the localizer to continue to your ascent.
All right, we'll continue on 180 and through the localizer through our descent for Air Transport 524.
Air Transport 524, descend and maintain 4,200.
4,200, Air Transport 524. All right, 4,200.
Air Transport 524, turn right heading 330.
Right to 330, Air Transport 524. 330, guys. 2,500. 679-330 right there. Maintaining our speed here. Looking good. Probably kill the drag here in a minute as we get to 4,200 feet where she wanted us at. Let's get our page over here onto the ILS mode.
524, turn right heading 360.
360 for Air Transport 524. 360 now. He's having us doing a crazy approach, but it's fun, you know? I like it. To turn the auto throttles off as they are seeming to be broken. I don't know why, but they are.
Air Transport 524, turn right heading 030.
030, Air Transport 524. All right, 030 now. keep an eye on our speed. Still at 4,200. What he's doing is he had us fly over the localizer and we're spinning around to catch it again, as per his instructions. In some turbulence here right now.
A transport 524, say speed.
Speed's at 250 right now, intro support 524.
Okay, transport 524, you're on the base right now for your vector. You really ought to slow down. Turn left heading 290 and slow to your approach speed.
290 will slow her up, air transport 524.
Yeah, transport 524, 3 miles from Pettis, maintain 4,000 till established on the localizer, cleared islands from a 26 right approach, and recommend you tighten up that turn or slow down, or a combination of both.
Alrighty, descend to 4,000, clear ILS 26 right for air transport 524. We're slowing her.
Yeah, you're already to the localizer, you didn't turn it tight enough. Turn the cancel your approach clearance, turn left heading 230 now.
Canceled approach 230, air transport 524. All right, we screwed that one up, guys. Let's try it again.
Your transport 524 KL, turn heading 230. You're 5 miles from Pettis. Maintain 4,000 to until establishing the localizer. Cleared ILS from 26 right approach.
Alrighty, 230 and 4,000 cleared for the ILS 26 right approach. Air transport 524. Thanks for your help. We're having some auto throttle issues.
A transport 524, roger, and you can actually maintain 3,000 now until establishing the localizer.
We'll make it 3,000, air transport 524. Now 3,000 like so. We'll arm the approach. Let's go flaps 5 now. Slow this puppy down.
2,500
check. Get our speed brakes open a little bit here. Stay underneath the tape.
Air transport 524, contact Ontario Tower 120.6.
Over to Ontario Tower on 120.6, air transport 524, and thanks for your help. Alrighty, we got 120.6. And 6. Come on. Ontario Tower, air transport 524 with you, ILS 26 right. One more power, gear down.
Air transport 524, Ontario Tower, good evening, runway, good afternoon, runway 26 right, clear to land, wind 280 at 5.
Clear to land, runway 26 right, air transport 524. All right, let's get our speed brakes armed, like so. Auto brakes 2. Manage the airplane on the way down. I have the airplane. Man, this thing is just acting like a big pile of garbage today. It's not liking not liking us at all. I don't know why it's been behaving so badly. The autopilot's just not working right. It's not, you know, I mean, we were on an approach. It wasn't capturing the approach correctly. So now we got to keep speed to this guy here. Let's go flaps 20.
Temitar 878, Charlie John Wayne ground, runway 20 left at Kilo, taxi via Alpha.
It's a good thing it wasn't like a crazy IFR approach. We would have been in trouble probably. We would have probably had to do a go around and try to get reestablished. It sucks whenever you're dealing with an airplane that's just not cooperating with you and doing what you want it to do. Instead, just, you know, kind of, we have auto throttles. But, you know, it's a simulator, so these quirks can happen and you just have to deal with them and take them, you know, with stride. Don't get too upset about it. And just do the best that we can. No, we're only human.
Five hundred.
Trim her back a little bit here. Right on the glide slope where we want to be.
400.
Little high, tad high.
Number 1073, camera. Good afternoon. Runway 26, taxi via Foxtrot Alpha.
Approaching minimums.
Push him in a tad high still. Just still a tad high. Bring her down. Keep down the speed all the way. Bring that nose up. Don't want to lose too much. Right there. There we go. Now she's starting to settle. I'm not trusting 50, that happy. That's 30, not correct.
30, 20,
20. 10. Ooh. Little bit of a bounce there. Not too much. Reverse thrust. Like so. They'll probably ask us where we're going to park and then all that good stuff. And 60
sounds like
knots.
A Golf Charlie Whiskey safe parking.
Like so. Auto brakes are off. We're just going to roll.
Delta Echo Golf Charlie Whiskey, say parking location.
All right, make our turn here. On to November.
Air Transport 524, say parking.
Headed over to cargo ramp. Air Transport 524.
North or south?
North is fine.
Air Transport 524, taxi to the ramp via Kilo and November. Remain the circuit. Say have a good day.
Taxi to the ramp, Kilo, November, with you. Air Transport 524, thanks.
Whiskey taxi to parking via Alpha. Remain in this frequency.
Alrighty, so while we're taxiing, we can go ahead and clean up the airplane, bring the flaps up, all that good stuff. Turn our landing lights off, don't need those on. We can leave the, what you call it on there, we turn our strobes off, we can leave our taxi lights on. And we'll taxi down to the cargo ramp. Alrighty, turning into a ramp right now. And then we will be all finished here in Ontario. You know, what an eventful flight. You know, I thought we were going to have a lot more IMC conditions, but I think, you know, I really need to get into the PMDG 737. I want a reliable autothrottle system. And I'm not saying it's this airplane. I think it's my CH throttle quadrant talking to the simulator. Seems to hate it. So maybe I need to check into that and see what's causing it before I blame it on something that it's not, you know? But anywho, you know, you deal with issues and you gotta deal with them, so... Right, that makes no sense. You have issues and you just have to deal with them. That's what I meant to say. You know, the best that you possibly can, so...
Canisar 84 Dolly, radar contact, stay altitude.
Call it for us right there. Park and brake is set. Always forget to start the APU. Not big deal. We can turn our... let's just wait for that APU to be available here. Just a little bit longer. Alrighty, let's shut her down. Both of those are off. Beacon off. And there you have it, guys. We made it here in one piece. You know, it's funny because, you know, you get rusty with an airplane and I'm brand new to the Pilot Edge on this end. You remember the only other flight we ever did on Pilot Edge was in the Cessna and doing a circuit.
Charlie, contact SoCal approach.
I understand how a lot of the ATC procedures work. That's why I'm able to do it. But definitely need more practice with it. So, guys, hit the like button if you enjoyed and I'll see you next time.
Number 10732, Camarillo Tower. Did you have the weather information? Wind 2505, altimeter 3003. Number 732, roger. Could not remember if you did or not. Thank you. Runway 26, right turnout approved, cleared for takeoff.